What's poppin', everyone? You got your coach of the Chim Chargers here today with our week 6 battle of the WBE. We're doing pretty well so far, and we're not even halfway done with the season, which is crazy. There's 13 weeks total. So I'm excited to play some more games, try to get the best record possible. I do believe that if we actually do get the best record possible in our bracket or like in our conference thing, then I'm pretty sure we get a bye, if I'm not mistaken, which would be kind of chill. So I like that. But anyways, we're going to be taking on my boy Aaron Cybertron, coach of the Melbourne Rotoms, for week 6. And as you can see by his team, he has Rotom Heat, Kartana, Mega Slowbro, Mamma Swine, Alolan Marowak, and Conkeldurr. Very, very scary team overall. So while trying to prep for this match, I realized that he just had a phenomenal matchup versus myself here with stuff like Alolan Marowak, Conkeldurr, even like Mamma Swine too. Like, there's not a lot to switch into those kinds of mons on my team. Then of course Mega Slowbro gonna be a very fat mon that we gotta deal with. Kartana has a variety of sets. It could be Band, Scarf, SD, maybe some other kind of item on it. And then Rotom, which might be defensive or offensive with Scarf maybe, I don't know. We'll have to find out. But he has two potential rockers on his team, being Mamoswine and Alolan Marowak, with I think two potential defoggers as well in the Rotom Heat as well as the Kartana. So very well, I think very well built team on his part versus myself. I think is a really solid matchup. But let's talk about my team here. So I'm bringing Rotom, of course, nice defogger, defensive Rotom, can be very useful versus some of his other Pokemon. Then I have Azumarill, which is going to be a Paris trapping Sapsipper Azu, so I'm excited to show that off in this one, hopefully. Heracross. So Heracross's debut, first time using this Pokemon in Draft League. I'm actually running a Choice Scarf Heracross, which I figured would be useful because it can actually outrun everything on his team bar a Scarfed Kartana, and I think a Scarf Rotom if it is max speed. But he doesn't really have a lot of great switches to Heracross because I have coverage for everything on his team. Then I have here a Scarf Ditto, so another Scarfer for the team. Dual Scarfers, so I have two Scarfer Mons there. I think it's useful because it can stop any kind of setup sweep from something like Kartana. It can revenge the Mamoswine and stuff as well if it's weakened, and also just be a really big threat to some of his more offensive mons. I have Victini, which is actually going to be a special attacking set with Fighting Z, specifically for things like the Mamoswine, the Rotom. He had Miltank on his overall roster, so I have that as well for if he decided to bring that Pokemon. And yeah, it has a lot of great mixed coverage, or not really mixed coverage, but just diverse coverage. And I think it's really nice versus him. And then I have Registeel just for the purpose of Stealth Rocks. I could have either brought that or Dugtrio just for rocks, but I figured Registeel provided a more solid switch in to certain attacks. And yeah, it's gonna be that. So my overall game plan going into this match was, if I can get up rocks, that'd be nice. It can chip down his team 25% versus things like his Rotom and the Alolan Marowak, and just provide chip damage. I think is really good to break any potential sashes. So if I can do that, that's great. Otherwise, you know, if I can weaken things potentially for something like a Moxie Heracross or my Victini, that could also be very solid as well. So let's just go ahead and get right into it. I figured he might want to lead maybe with either the Rotom or the Mamoswine. I think those are his two best leads. I guess maybe also Marowak if it does have rocks, but I think the first two mons that I just mentioned are his most likely leads. So let's just get right into it and see how we do in this match versus Cybertron, my boy Aaron. He decides to challenge me, and this may or may not be his first mistake. So he leads off with the Rotom, kind of what I expected. Figured that he might lead with his to scout with Volswitch. I lead off with my own Rotom for the exact same purpose, scouting with Volswitch. And I'm just going to go right for that right now. I am faster naturally, but he could also be a defensive Rotom because I didn't have too much speed invested in me. So I'm going to actually Volswitch out into my Ditto just to kind of see what moves he had. And I do believe he had Volswitch, Overheat, Foul Play, and Defog. So it didn't really tell me a lot about its item just seeing that, but it could be a lot of different things. He Volswitches into Conkeldurr as I just decide now to Volswitch out of this thing because there's no point in me staying in if it's AV Conkeldurr, and that damage kind of made me believe it was. So I'm going to go here into my Heracross predicting knockoff versus my Rotom. He does go right for the knockoff, gets rid of my Choice Scarf, which is not bad because his team doesn't look overly fast. So I can just go ahead and click close combat here to get as much damage as I can on Conkeldurr, and he goes right for the drain punch, which does do a decent amount of damage to myself, but he doesn't really heal himself back enough to live the next close combat, which I do go for right here. So maybe he might have thought I would overpredict or something and go for another move, maybe predicting a switch out. But I do get rid of the Conkeldurr, and that is fantastic because that thing was kind of a threat to my team. So now here he's going to go into his Mamoswine, and I'm going to switch out, predicting the Ice Shard here because my Heracross is at -2. I don't want to get knocked out by an Ice Shard. So I'm going to go here into Rotom, as he actually pulls a double into his Marowak, which is a pretty good play. Like, he, I guess, figured that I'd switch out of Ice Shard. And because Marowak is another huge threat, I'm just going to go for the Hex here. I know it won't Oko. I know Shadow Bone, which he does go for here, will Oko me. But I know, I figured that maybe just weakening Marowak would be really great to sort of pick it off later on with another attack, because Marowak and Conkeldurr were probably the two biggest threats to my team. So I'm going to go Victini here and click Psychic, which is a guaranteed Oko on Marowak should he have stayed in. But he goes into his Rotom, which actually gets 2-hit KO'd by Psychic. And that's crazy. We get a lot of damage off on that. So now the Rotom is gone. That's fantastic, because this thing, that Rotom could have been a little bit annoying for some of our other members. And he brings in Mamoswine, as I'm like, oh, this is perfect. I'm going to switch up my moves right here. Go for the Fight EMZ Focus Blast and hit this thing up for a lot of damage. I'm going to go for the All Out Pummeling here versus Mamoswine. He might have thought I was locked in or something because of that Rotom got 2-hit KO'd. But nah. I'm going to hit him up right here and knock out Mamoswine. Get rid of that Pokemon, and that thing is gone. So Victini already just knocking out things back to back. That's crazy. Now he brings in Slowbro, right? Check this out. Okay, check this one out. He's going to Mega Evolve here. He's going to go for the Mega Evolution, get into his Mega Form to boost his defenses and whatnot. But I'm going to just drop a fat Thunder on this thing. Look at this. Drop a Thunder here, and that's going to do a clean chunk of damage. This, of course, is an Oko because I'm unboosted or anything, but still does a decent amount of damage. As he actually sets up Trick Room, he brought Trick Room to the Trick House. And we know the rules about that. You never bring Trick Room to the Trick House, because I'm going to go out here into my Azu. So I go out into Azu predicting maybe like a water type offensive move or something, but he goes for the Slack Off. That's fine. You know, he wants to heal himself up. Perfectly fine. But now he's going to go for the Scald here, and he does snag the burn. If I was any kind of offensive set, then that would have been bad. However, I am the Whirlpool Paris trapping Azu, so I'm going to make sure that he stays in. Trap him right here. And that's great now, because Slowbro, if it does not have like a psychic type move or something to do bigger damage to Azu, is basically gone here. Either way should be gone because of the fact that I can just Perish Song on this turn. I also have Protect on this Azu to scout, or not to scout, but mainly to use it with Perish Song to go hand in hand so that we can stall out turns. And it was also a sort of a way for me to scout other moves on some of his more offensive mons. But yeah, I could just go right for that here and stall out another turn of Perish Song, so that there would only be, two turns left after this. And so the Whirlpool damage is chipping him. Doesn't really matter because of the fact that there are only two turns left for both parties to survive. Now, I'm going to go here for the Protect once again. I just figured it was my best play because I was not doing any damage with Whirlpool anyways, and double Protect might have been nice to avoid any other damage. I don't get it, but that's fine, because now at this point in time, I get to switch out and this Slowbro will go down to the Perish Song. So he's trapped. He can't switch, but I can. So I'm going to go here into my Ditto. I figured that would be my best switch in here, because should he decide to get up Trick Room once again, I have my own Mega Slowbro to use that. So he actually goes to the Trick Room here, and so he did get the Trick Room up. Perish Song knocks him out here. That's phenomenal. And now I got a Slowbro in versus his team with Trick Room up. So he goes into Kartana here. Instead of attacking, because I didn't see a move that could Oko Kartana, I'm going to switch out here into Azu. As he goes for Leaf Blade, I have the Sap Sipper, which will allow me to be immune to that. And now check this out, okay? Check this out. I'm under Trick Room right now, right? I'm under Trick Room. I got the tech, okay? I got the tech HP Fire to knock out Kartana in one hit. And that thing is gone. So that's amazing. Getting rid of Kartana here. Azu under Trick Room too. So keep in mind, never bring Trick Room to the Trick House. For anybody that plays me, for anybody watching, you know the rules. You know the rules of my house. So here at this point in time, my way to win, or my guaranteed way to win, is to just sack mons until I'm able to bring in a Pokemon that can work well outside of Trick Room, because none of my other mons can really sort of touch this thing that's slower than it or faster than other Trick Room. So Trick Room wears off, I get to go Victini here and knock it out with a Psychic. Psychic's a guaranteed Oko, so the crit did not matter there. And that is going to be GG. It is Emvee. So really solid game overall. We got to really sort of show off some of the mons that I guess really wanted to. I mean, we got to see Heracross knock out Conkeldurr 1v1, Hercules, the fighter right there. And then we got to see sort of like, I guess, the Azu tech that I had here put in so much work, you know, being able to do exactly what it was supposed to do, trap Slowbro, knock it out, HP fire Kartana. And that was that too under Trick Room. So kind of crazy. And of course, Victini set was definitely one of the MVPs for sure, being able to knock out Rotom and Alolan Marowak as well as Mamoswine with the Z move. So a really solid game overall, I think. And of course, GG to Aaron. You know, always a pleasure to play with you, my friend. And yeah, I really like how he sort of learns after each match. I've seen a couple of his games where he like sort of analyzes towards the end, and or I guess also throughout the game. So it's always fun to watch his vids, and be sure to check him out, of course, as I don't know if he'll be uploading at the same time, but his game should be going up as well in livecom format, so I'll be watching that as well. And yeah, thank you everybody for watching. Hope you all enjoyed this match, and feel free to let me know what you guys think, of course. I think we did really well this week, a really solid victory, 3-0 victory in this matchup. So especially when I figured like the matchup was really bad versus myself, and I think we did pretty well for that fact. But that's going to be that. I'll see you guys on the next video, and peace.